Huh. I feel like a complete idiot now. So, I've been up there, yeah. I'm in the nether, by the way, at the top of the nether. And I just started building my zombie pigment farm. I mean, restarted doing it, because I wasn't happy with the design I was gonna do, so I decided to go with the one I've seen done recently, and I'm not even sure about the size of that circle, right? But I've been jumping down, yeah, and for some reason I couldn't fly. And that got me really puzzled, because I jumped down twice and I was down to 1.5 hearts. Do you know why I couldn't fly? Didn't have my latches on. I knew this would happen to everyone one day, but I didn't expect that to happen to me anytime soon. So, yeah. I don't know when I'm actually going to record the actual episode, because this is just a little thing I wanted to say, because I feel really stupid now. But yeah, I'll just get on with some building. Okay, I don't know how bad of an idea this is. I just had some pigmen spawn, because I guess I got a little far away from where they Never mind, basically I've got some pigmen spawn. I think I got this a little too close to what it should be. I think the actual distance it should be on the outer side of the circle, but I just want to see if I'll anger the pigmen downstairs. Okay, I know I've angered these guys. This is going to end too well for me. Okay, I got my latches on this time. Yeah, okay. Now, did I anger the pigmen down there? I can hear them. They don't sound happy. Whoops. What? What did I just do? How did I literally just fall? Okay. I don't think they're angry. But that is a lot of them. I better light this place up, because I'm gonna get a lot of pigmen spawning here. But they're not angry, so that's good. Yay! Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another episode of Minecraft. And sorry about the intro, I didn't expect to record, but I decided to. And can you guess where I am? Wrong. I'm very high up. And I'm just gonna go straight down, because I'm an idiot. It's actually taking a long time. Yeah. What? Just happened. I was too shocked to speak. What? Oh, I'm gonna die. Again. Of course, two deaths in one go. Smart. If I didn't make that, I would have been pretty angry. But yeah, I worked in the farm a little bit, and then I got really bored. How did my XP end up all the way here? Alright. That was pretty embarrassing. No. Okay, they're all up there. For some reason, I thought they would have gone in the lava. That's actually quite possible. Oh boy. What's a good start to an episode? Ain't it? Oh my god. By the way, I was not meant to die. That was an accident. Okay. Let's see what I lost. Doesn't look like I lost anything really. Huh. I didn't lose anything. Don't think. Just rearranging my inventory now. Sweet. But anyways, the main biggest reason actually is to get more food. That's why I got back here. But of course, I just got bored as well, and that was very embarrassing. And I need to smelt up my potatoes, so I'm just gonna put them in here. That's all the brick I have left, plus a stack of blocks. But yeah, this episode, new challenge, pirate speak. Just this episode though, because I won't be able to do it for long. Okay, where is it? And that's lots of languages. Pirate speak, where are you? Pirate speak? Pirate speak? Come on. I actually don't know what it's called. I'm pretty sure it's pirate speak, right? Probably near the top, actually. Ah, here it is. Did my game just freeze? I think it did. Oh boy. Okay, I got it loaded up and I just crashed, by the way. So, I've already played in pirate speak sometimes, like once, but I don't remember much. Speed is full sails. Regen is fountain of youth. Makes sense for a pirate. Ship's bane. That didn't change. Tough. 3. Knock cuffed. 2. Embarrassed cutlass. 2. Lutin. 3. Scarring. 5. Okay. Usefulness. Arrow O'Plenty. Cannibal knockback 2. Vigor 5. This is fun. Bloody beetroots, wow. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna do this for the whole thing. Okay. This is actually a lot of fun. If I died there. Ottoman Corsair's Wood. Okay, whatever. I'll try to get through the episode normally without having to stop to read. Hey, I got it off the ground first time. That's an achievement. Yay! But yeah, what we're gonna do today is probably work on the what I was talking about yesterday. Oh wow, beetroots are so bad. I actually never had beetroots before. Like, in real life, of course I did, but not in Minecraft. So I'm gonna work on the control room here, and there's a lot of mobs there. So for that... Wait, I'm actually that lazy. Okay, I'll need a whole bunch of redstone. I'll need a lot of redstone, actually. None of that. You know what, I'll just collect materials off camera. Check this out, guys. Scarlo the Corrupted Bag o' Bones. That's a mouthful. Wealth o' the Ocean. Larswood. Larswood. Logbook. Name your mate. Chanko Lizwood. Rogo Full Thales. Rum. What's that? Is... One gulp down. Oh, I love this. Grogo healing. Quick healing 2. This is too much fun. Spider eyeball. Fresh beef. Ball o' slime. Tear o' ghast. Black powder. I thought it was gunpowder. Leather. Okay. Tall man's treasure. This doesn't sound right. Cheap rope. Putrid rations. Bone. Kraken's paint. This is too much fun. And by the way, I just realized I'm all out of iron. So I'm gonna have to go caving. And I did it first try again. Heh, I just got 2 carrots in a row. He's down, he's down. No, he's not. Yeah, perfect. Come on. For some reason the F line doesn't work when I'm pressing control. Okay, so the first job is to carefully mine everything out, so to basically make a big room. And I'm actually gonna lower that by like 5 blocks. I don't know, about 5, maybe just 3. Because I'm gonna be needing to put a thing over there, up there, for, what's it called? Be able to one hit kill the mobs, basically, so it's only gonna be 23 blocks full, so I'm gonna have to put some water down there. But the mobs need to have fallen some bit for it to actually work, otherwise they'll just swim. And actually not that bad of a job lighting this up. Oh, that's a bad job. I don't like that either. Let's just face it, I'm not the best person at lighting things up. But I did my job, okay. Nothing spawning there. So, need to widen. Is this skylight by any chance? Oh, okay. I get distracted easily, okay? So I need to make a big room, a fair-sized room, even, not big, just fair-sized. So I'll just do that off camera, maybe. Okay, I've got the room pretty much laid out now. The hopper's gonna go over here, so it's 2 blocks down, and that's pretty much what I was aiming for. I'm gonna build the entrance much later, pretty much after I finish building the main room. So, whilst I do this, here's a maths question for you guys. It's not very complicated. Everyone, even in the bottom set, you should be able to do this. Although, maybe not this particular question, but you should be familiar with averages, right? So, here is a question. So, a motorbike is going from point A to point B at 40 miles per hour. Then, on the way back, so from point B to point A, it's going at 60 miles per hour. What is the average speed? Ooh. I'll give you a little bit of time to think. It's pretty simple. Although, not really. Okay, time's up. What did you think? Did you say 50 was the average speed? You're wrong. The average speed is actually 48. And you might be thinking, well, how the hell did I come up with that idea? Well, here's the thing. I'm just gonna type it into chat after I light this up. Here is how you do it. So you have V as the speed, because that's the scientific way of doing it. So velocity 1. This is how you would think of it. Divided by that equals 100, right? Then what you did is take that 100 and divide it by 2, which equals, equals 50, right? But you did it wrong, because that's not how it's actually done. Yeah, it's done like that in math, and that's how they teach you, but scientifically, really not. In physics, what it is 2 multiplied by V1, multiplied by V2, then in brackets, divided by, and then in brackets, V1 plus V2. So, multiplied by 2, So this bit here is multiplied by 2. I don't know what this means, actually. I think that's just the player code. So what this thing, the whole thing is multiplied by 2, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it is. So V1 is 40 multiplied by V2, which is 60, and that gives us, hold on a second, I just need to finish working this out. That gives us 2,400, right? So V1 multiplied by V2 equals 2,400. Then you take that, yeah. You have to have the brackets there. So you take the 2,400 and you divide that by 40, add 60, which is 100. That gives you 24, but the whole thing is times by 2. So 2,400 divided by 100 equals 24. But the whole, since the whole thing at the beginning is multiplied by 2, it is 48. Smart. Alright, so a few days later now, as usual, I haven't had time to record, but I did have time to play. So, I kind of went to the Infinite End, and I kind of got myself some shulker boxes, and they're actually pretty useful. I used one for, caving, because I could put all my stuff in there, and I also made the lights go, they also go on and off there, so I'm just going to turn them off because I'm doing maintenance work. So that turns them off, on. So, yeah, doing some maintenance work. If there's still going to be a few mobs up there, so I'm just going to wait for them all to fall down. But meanwhile, I'm just going to half slap this floor here, because then it will make it much easier to work, and I won't have to light up the whole place. I mean, like, the whole floor, because that would be a big pain to do. So Hopper will go there. This is all the stuff I've got from it so far. There's going to be a sorting system over there. I'm actually not going to have this lever here because currently I have no idea what it's going to be used for. So since this is all going to be like this, I can put the hoppers underneath these. And whatever I drop here is going to go in the hopper, actually. So that's going to be fun, if I accidentally drop something like my Elytras. But it'll just go in the chest. I will have to make an item sorting thing, which I don't like doing. I'm not the best person to do item sorting. You'll have to ask someone like Etho, because he's the master of item sorters. This chest will have to be moved. I'm not sure I'll keep all of this stone brick. I actually don't like it that much anymore, because I've just used it so many times. But for now, I'm just going to use that, because I don't have anything else to put here. Actually, I could have used wood. Also, I'd like to, like, round this room a little bit. Make it look like it's a bit more of a technical thing. Ah! I'm not a huge fan of working here. And also I went on a caving trip, because after this episode I'm just gonna go and finish the hell thing. The thing I can't finish. What's it called? I don't even remember what it's called now. The tunnel, yeah. I want to finish the tunnel off camera after this episode. So just do that. I'm just going to drop everything into there, because I can. That hit. That's slow. Okay. Well, I'm just gonna let that sort for now. So I'm gonna have this here so that, like, no mobs can get out if they don't die, and that can also kill them, simply. Also, I'll do this so that they can't, so if it's a skeleton, it can't shoot me, because then it wouldn't be able to track me. Well, actually, it would probably be able to shoot me alright. I don't think through well, do I? It'll be able to shoot me, but it'll have a lot of difficulty. Well, a lot more difficulty, I should say. So cover this up for now. And just to prove that this will pick items up. Yep, it's in here. Next, I will do this. So the mobs kind of like have this little chute to fall down. I actually love working on this. It's a lot of fun. And even though I'm in the tag, I just said I hate working on this. In a way I do, in a way I don't. My least favorite part is probably designing it. Because it's so hard to come up with something that looks good underground. Or at all. Also, I can pick up the stuff that's there, so if there's any XP, it will come towards me. What did I just pick up? A torch, okay. So over here is going to be a big chest room, full of all the things that have been chopped by the mobs. Okay, now I'll pause recording. I'm not very good at this. Alright, so I got this room figured out now, and for the first time I'm actually using these chiseled stone bricks. I haven't seen anyone use them in literally years, and they look pretty good for places like buttons and levers. That looks pretty cool actually. And also over here, I thought I'd add a little more texture to it. So now I just need to add some color to it, and that'll be like fine. So what I'm gonna put here, these are chests, so these compartments are for chests. They're gonna be facing this way, so they're gonna be double chests like this. And there's gonna be extra storage, so gonna be rotten flesh, then bones, gunpowder, arrows, and random things from like witches and helmets and crap like that. And the reason I put zombie flesh here and random stuff there is because zombie flesh is useless, random stuff is useless. Bones, arrows come from skeletons and gunpowder right in the middle, because that's what the whole point of this is. I love gunpowder. So yeah, I need to get these hoppers going in that direction now, and then I'm gonna need to make an item sorter going all around this, and yeah, I still have quite a bit more to do. Something like 3 hours later now. Super tired. Have well overplayed now. But it's done, guys. The system works, and the item elevator for this works. This is the last thing to do. And it should work. Hey, why is there... Oh yeah, okay. I was like, why is there random stuff? And I was like... And I was testing, like, the very start. Okay, got my redstone blocks back. Now we're still in the system. So... Alright, rotten flesh is all first, okay. There's a lot of stuff. So this is the chest for rotten flesh. Bones, gunpowder, arrows, junk. And I'm just gonna let that run for a few hours, because there's so much stuff here. Oh my god. I'm so happy that I finished this, but at the same time, I pretty much wasted 12 hours or something like that. Nah, it's just 3 hours. Felt like 12 because I just had to pause for some time. So, what's it doing now? Didn't jam, did it? Ah, it's doing gunpowder. It just takes a little bit of time for it to get through everything. Because there's a lot of stuff. But I'm very happy with this. I'm not going to show you the item sorting thing because it would take way too long and I'm like over my recording time now. It's like 25 minutes in. So I'm just going to wait for this to finish doing its thing. The lights are off there, so mobs are still falling. But yeah. I'm going to do the floor and the ceiling off camera. And I'm going to make this room look a little bit nicer because I'm still not happy with it. Is it done yet? There's so much junk! Look how... Arrow should be coming in about now, unless I messed it up. They should be going in here. Okay, yeah. None of the items weren't sorted out yet. But yeah. After a long time, these chests are all going to be full, eventually. But, yeah. I am in the new snapshot now, 16W41A, and there's actually something pretty cool, something that is, I think is pretty cool, but it's going to take me a little bit of time to get used to it. These colours on the bottom of the items, the bars, are now more on the spectrum, rather than just... it's smooth, the transition is smoother now, so it used to be like green, then would be, there was no this color for example, it would just go to this, then it would go to a yellow, like the gold over there, and then it would go to red, and then very red, and it would be like, it would basically be like that, but yeah, stuff changed. So much stuff. Yeah, it's for all the tools, and I'm pretty happy with it. I'll take the redstone. yeah, so I'll just... There's lots of these guys for some reason. But yeah, see you in just a second, when I go to do the TNT. But anyways, guys! It is that time again to end the episode. Done quite a bit this episode actually. Even though it's just one thing, it's been quite a bit of stuff. That is so useful to have an item sorter. Believe me guys, when you build something like that, have an item sorter. And this is like 25 pieces of TNT, so let's go. I missed. Missed again. Missed again. Do this. Yeah. It should be like this every episode. Except it's gonna be even bigger, because I'm gonna let my mob system run for like 3 hours straight. Just AFK at it, and get all the gunpowder I need. Oh yeah, that was 25 pieces of gunpowder. There's a cave somewhere. And we're actually really far down now. Should expect some gold soon. I don't even know why I'm doing this anymore. Like, I said that I'm going to build something big, but then I was lying to you guys, I just wanted to blow something up. I just wanted to have some kind of way to end an episode. But yeah, it's fun to blow things up anyway, so... Hope you don't mind, but yeah, thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.